Okay, today we're reviewing this. This is from UGEARS, and it is a model dynamometer. It's a kit of wooden parts cut from thin plywood that assembles into a dynamic geared model, which looks quite interesting, doesn't it? So let's have a look and see. Okay, so the kit inside is nicely wrapped. I can see there's a instruction manual there. Toothpicks, I presume, are the spindles. Right, let's open it up carefully. Okay, let's have a look at the instruction manual. Some stickers there, okay. So yes, the instruction manual's got colour diagrams which appear to be quite clear. Numbered parts, and the numbers correspond with numbering on the laser cut pieces. Let's have a look at the actual pieces themselves. So, yeah, these are laser cut pieces. Now, you might have seen models like this to make non-moving things that are die cut, and they're typically a little bit poorer quality than this. This actually looks like it's quite high quality and precisely cut, and I imagine that's probably quite important for something that has to have that has moving parts. So why don't we have a go at building this? So step one is get piece number one, which is this large gear here. Let's pop that out. Let's just have a quick look at the parts. So yeah, very nicely laser cut. And no burrs or ragged edges or anything on the laser cut parts, so pretty good. Okay, so we want part number one and two of part number five. Part number five is here. Tiny little bit difficult to pop out some of these things, but you just have to wiggle them back and forth and then they do come out. Yeah, there we go. They're just quite finely cut really, so they fit very tightly into their little hole, but they do come out quite cleanly. So that is like that. Nope, like that. And part numbers five go in with the shorter stubs into there and there with the curved, there's a little curved section just there. Oops, that's popped out again. Right, so that goes into there. Oops, wrong way around. Got to be a bit careful here. They're all quite intricate pieces. I guess it probably matters quite a lot which way they go together. So that's that part. Next I need two of piece number four, which is these two here. So again, got to wiggle them a little bit to get them out. I think the smaller parts are probably just that little bit more difficult to pop out than the larger ones will be, just because it's hard to put any pressure on a small part like that. So here we go. So these two pieces here go in again, curved side onto there and there. So that's step two. Step three, we need one of part number two. There is only one part number two. It's this piece here. Whoops. So, and it goes onto there like that. We'll be right back. quite a clever piece of design there. The action of forcing that toothpick into there pushes those pieces apart and wedges that wheel on there actually quite tightly. That's really quite clever. Okay, final assembly time. Assembled model. It does need a little bit of fine tuning. fine-tuned that now, and that's the Geneva mechanism there. Well, let's have a look and see if we can see that working. What happens there is a little pin comes round, engages in the rose wheel there, pushes it on, and then the wheel engages with its with the round wheel there, so it makes a sort of ticking motion. Like I say, it still needs a little bit of fine tuning. Okay, so let's see if we can actually show you that Geneva drive in action. So just keep an eye on down here. This round wheel here, it comes round, that little pin there engages in a slot in the wheel right here. And that gives it a little turn, and then the curved part of the wheel prevents it turning further until that pin comes round again and engages in the next slot. So, what do we think of this model? Actually, I quite enjoyed making this. It was just hard enough to be interesting, and it was just easy enough to be fun. So that's good. That was about my level, really. The design is great. It's really precision made. Really quite impressed with the quality of the build. It was quite sensible in terms of spares. They give you a few little spares of things that you're actually probably quite likely to break. So there were a couple of spare toothpicks in there for spindles, which is good because I broke one. And there are a couple of these little pegs spare. There are spare stickers in the book because, again, these are the things you're going to mess up actually if you make when you're making the model. So that was quite good. The quality of the laser cutting is just excellent, and for that reason it was actually quite hard to pop out some of the small pieces. I actually had quite a bit of trouble getting these little pegs out of the wood. In fact, this is probably my only criticism. What I would have done if I was designing this kit, I think I probably would have cut a laser line along here in between the parts, so this could just be broken apart to release those small parts. That's really my only gripe with the whole thing, which is kind of such a trivial thing anyway, it doesn't matter. What I would say is if you're making one of these, if you're going to buy one of these and make it, read the manual, study the manual before you start. I didn't do that, I just dived straight in, and so I missed a few little tips, like the fact that you have to use a candle to wax the spindles and a few other parts, and I missed a few things, just like the purpose of this little measuring tool that is included. This is for measuring the length of spindles that you leave sticking out and the distance between wheels and so on. Again, quite a cunning little piece of design there. It's also used for pushing in the toothpicks. It engages on the end of the toothpick there. Gives you something to push the thing inside the spindles, which is, again, very clever. So, all in all, clever design, fun to make. The manual's excellent, really. You need to study it, but really the manual's ever so nice and clear, and I'm quite pleased with this. Yeah, and it's a fun thing to have on the shelf, on display. And so, yeah, it does this thing, as you can see, when you turn it there, the little dial moves one step at a time. That's what the Geneva drive does. This is a sponsored review. The good people at UGEARS gave me this model free to evaluate and assemble, and it's been a lot of fun. They've also given me another one to give away to one of my viewers, so if you'd like to win one of these, there's a competition which is open until the end of February 2017. If you'd like to win one of these, all you have to do to enter is post in the comments of this video, pick me, and I will choose one comment at random at the end of February, and UGEARS will send this kit out to that winner. So, good luck. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you again soon.